Good morning, children. I am teacher Shobha. In today's class, we will learn about history's second chapter on the trails of the earliest people. Here is a story about Tushar's train journey. Tushar was going from Delhi to Chennai for his cousin's wedding with his uncle. They were traveling by train and he had managed to take a window seat with his nose glued to the glass pane. As he watched trees and houses fly past, his uncle tapped his shoulder and asked, "Do you know that trains were first used about 150 years ago and that people began using buses a few years later?" Tushar wondered and started thinking that when people couldn't travel quickly from one place to another, did they spend their entire lives wherever they were born? Did they live in a single place? Now let us find out why the earliest people, our ancestors, were traveled from place to place and why they were on the move. We will know about people who lived in the subcontinent as early as 2 million years ago. Today we describe them as hunters and gatherers. The names came from the way in which they got their food. Hunters hunted animals, birds, and caught fish. And gatherers gathered food, mainly plant products, in the tropical land like our country India, where there is a moderate climate and there is a thick forest cover, so they got immense plant products. They gathered roots, fruits, seeds, leaves, stalks of plant and eggs. So these things were not easy to do. There are several animals that run faster than us. Many are stronger and many can run faster than man, such as deer and rabbit. To hunt animals or catch fish and birds, people needed to be alert. And they needed to be quicker than animals. And they should have lot of presence of mind. To collect plant produce, they need to find out which plants or part of plants was edible that can be eaten. So, many plants can be poisonous too. So you need to find out about the reasons or the seasons when the fruits ripen. There are at least four reasons why hunters and gatherers moved from place to place. First, if they stayed at one place for a long time, they would have eaten up all the available plant and animal resources. Therefore, they wanted to go from place to place in search of food. Secondly, the animals move from place to place, either in search of smaller prey or in the case of grass, in search of grass and leaves, deers and the wild cattle. They go in search of grass. That is why those who hunted them had to follow their movements. Thirdly, the plants and the trees which bear fruit in different seasons. So people may have moved from season to season in search of different kinds of plants. Fourth reason is the people, plants and animals needed water to survive, and water is found in lakes, streams and rivers. While many rivers and lakes are perennial, means with water flowing throughout the year, and some others are seasonal, which flow only during rainy season. People living on their banks would have had to go in search of water during the dry seasons, that is winter and summer season. Besides these reasons, people may have traveled to meet their friends and relatives, and they traveled on foot from place to place. And how do we know about these people? Archaeologists have found some of the things what hunters, gatherers made and used. These people made and used tools of stone, wood and bone. Which of these some stones have survived best? Children, if you look at these stones, tools, Can you guess what these tools were used for? And try to decide which of these tasks could be performed using a natural pebble or a stone. So, some of these stone tools were used to cut meat and bone of the animals and scrap bark from the trees, and hides means taking out the skin of the animals, chopping fruits and roots. Some stones may have been attached to handles of bone and wood to make spears and arrows for hunting. Other tools were used to chop wood, which was used as firewood. Wood was also used to make huts to live and to make tools. Some stone tools were also being used for digging the ground to collect edible roots. Some were used to stitching the clothes made out of animal skin. As stone tools were important, people tried to find places where good quality stone was easily available. Places where stone was found and where people made tools were known as factory sites. How do you know where these factories were found? And usually we find blocks of stones, tools that were made, and some were discarded because they were not perfect, and the chips of waste stone were left behind at these sites. Sometimes people lived here and for longer spells of time. These sites were called as habitation cum factory sites. In the next class, children, we will learn about the sites where earlier people lived and how stone tools were made.